What's up guys, I hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. My name is Rahul and welcome back to Rahul in Wonderland. Today is another weekend and we are out of our house to explore another weekend destination. Since it's the start of the holiday season, I thought of starting up a new season, a new series known as Weekend Destinations Nearby Bangalore. So please watch this full season. What I'm going to do is, I'm gonna take you to the various destinations, the weekend destinations around Bangalore, which are very near to Bangalore, maybe an hour or a 2 hours drive. And I will try to explore these places. Some of the places are unique places, hidden places, which are not explored much by the tourists. So stay tuned. So this is the episode number one of season one. And today we are in Gudi Bande Fort. So behind me, you can see this is the Gudi Bande Fort. We are gonna climb this fort. And I will be sharing the history of this fort and some interesting information and interesting facts about this fort on the way. So this fort is around like 80 to 90 kilometers from Bangalore. It just takes a couple of hours from Bangalore to drive here. It's a National Highway 7, the Hyderabad Highway, so you know the road is pretty good. It just takes like less than 2 hours to reach here by car or a bike. So now we are here, the time is around 11:20. We started at around 9:30 something. So we will start the trek up the fort. It takes 1 hour. There are some steps on the way and in between there are some rock climbings as well. So let's go and explore the fort. Come with me. So just 15 minutes up the fort and we have reached this place where the steps are no more now. So it's all the rock climbing up here and there you can see we have to reach there. That's the fort behind me. And this side the view is incredible. That's the Bhairav Sagara. It's known as the Bhairav Sagara. It's incredible view. Minutes of climb and we have reached this place. Behind me you can see the walls of the fort are visible now. So I think another 40 minutes of the climb. There are some interesting facts that I wanted to share about this fort. Number one is, do you know who is the Robin Hood of India or the Robin Hood of Vijayanagara Empire? There was a guy named as Bhairav Gowda. So he was a ruler in the Vijayanagara Empire, and he built this fort, which is known as the Gudibande. So Gudibande, this fort, was built by Bhairagauda. Bhairagauda was a ruler in the Vijayanagara Empire, and he was also known as the Robin Hood of Vijayanagara Empire. The reason is, he used to rob the rich people and he used to benefit the poor people out of it. So that's why he is known as the Robin Hood. How? It's a little bit dark here. It's kind of a shelter that we are here. So that's one interesting fact about Bhairagauda. You can Google him. So another interesting fact about this Gudibande fort is, Bhairagauda had designed this fort in such a way to protect soldiers with the best possible escape routes. Now if you look behind me, there are like 7 levels of this fort, and he has designed this kind of escape routes. There are numerous escape routes on this fort, with the help of which the soldiers used to escape in case of an emergency, in case of any attack from the enemies. So this is another interesting fact. The second interesting fact about this fort is this temple over here. This is known as the Rameshwara temple, and it is believed that sage Vishwamitra and Lord Rama established this temple over here. And this Jyotirling is one of the 108 Jyotirlingas. I think the gate is locked. We'll try to view the temple from the gate itself. Come on. So guys, I'm at the topmost point of the Gudibande Fort, and this is how the view is. That's the road from where we came. That's the viewpoint. That's the Bairi Sagara. Oh, Bairi Gowda had a topmost rain harvesting system designed on this fort. Now the one pond that you see below there, right? That's not in a good state now, but Bairi Gowda had 19 rock ponds on this fort. And the wonderful part about it is they were interconnected with each other. And this fort had a capacity of storing around 3 lakh liters of water in the 17th century. Can imagine. So we are done exploring the Gudibande Fort and now we are heading down. So the climb down will be very easy one compared to the climb up. It might take just half an hour or 40 minutes to go down. So let's see you down. Finally, the time is around 1 o'clock. Sorry, 1:30, and we have climbed down Gudibande Fort. So this fort is situated at a distance of around 80 kilometers from Bangalore city. It's just a couple of hours drive. I will include the map in the description, so you can follow the Google map and you can reach here. This is a wonderful place. Make sure that you carry your water bottle and some snacks. And do not litter the place because we found some places where there were a lot of garbage thrown, so it's not good. So yeah, all in all, a wonderful journey.